Hello, a warm welcome to you all. Again, this is Dr. Vijay. I'm a maxillofacial surgeon cum senior implantologist of Partha Dental clinics and hospitals, respectively. Partha Dental is a renowned dental corporate chain which comprises of 80 plus odd dental clinics in Andhra, Telangana, and Bangalore. Okay, Partha Dental infrastructure includes the latest dental chain with advanced sterilization equipment, etc. They have an advanced diagnostic equipment too, which includes an intraoral camera, orthopantomographer, which analysis or dental X-ray kind of a thing, and it's the quality and sterilization in Partha Dental is unachievable to any other organization. Partha Dental is qualified to handle all super specialty requirements in the dental field of dental sciences. It is backed up with all the resources in terms of equipment, and Partha Dental comprises of around 250 super specialists and around 1500 assisting supporting staff. And Partha Dental is the largest chain in South India, and it is in a position of warranties for a majority of the procedures. So Partha Dental has got numerous records and patients as perspectives have got a great law, great testimonials, videos, etc. So whichever you wanted to have a check-in, you can have a log on to Facebook, through Twitter, Instagram, etc. And Partha Dental usually treats the patients. It is in need of a common man. So whomever wants a dental procedures, everybody who requires a dental treatments and all can easily come to Partha Dental, get the best out of the services in rendered in Partha Dental. So today my topic is, I'll be speaking on the role of a maxillofacial surgery. As a maxillofacial surgeon, I would like to talk about maxillofacial surgery, the role of a maxillofacial surgery in dentistry. So I would like to talk about the trauma, orthognathic surgeries, dental implants, cleft lip and palate surgeries, and residual deformities, like after trauma you have a residual deformity, you don't have a great facial contour. So what is to be done, what is to be dealt in that, and the cosmetic procedures like facial enhancements and rhinoplasty, lip debulking, lip lengthening procedures, etc. So we're going to discuss today about all those surgical topics. Okay, and anybody who wants to have something, some questions in your mind and all, could join me. I am very free to answer you all your questions regarding dentistry. Okay, and this is Dr. Vijay again. I'm a maxillofacial surgeon and senior implantologist of Partha Dental. Okay, so Partha Dental is a renowned corporate dental chain, and the chairman himself is Dr. Partha Sarthi, who belongs to the holy city called Tirupati. He has done his bachelor of sciences in the government dental college and his master's in Osmania Dental College. He's been practicing for 7 to 8 years in Tirupati. Then later on, he realized the dental services should not be rendered only to Tirupati. It has to be spread throughout the world, worldwide. So he has started his the next branch in Hyderabad, moved on to Hyderabad. From there, his journey didn't stop as of now. So he is a great pioneer of dentistry. He's got a great leadership qualities. So the main factors and key of success to Partha Sarthi is the practice, which is a combination of a technology. He gets every technology into Partha Dental. Every doctor has been given a chance to prove his skills towards by this. He's created a great platform to all the dentists who have freshly come out and wanted to have a great bright future. So he's been rendered everything to all the doctors and to the society. And he has that uncanny ability to visualize the need of an effort, which has been brought him a great kind of results. So let me just move on to a little bit of a chat. There's been a few messages posted in here. Tilak's Gowda, extraction and implant costs need to be informed. That's a great question, sir. It is not that expensive procedures these days. We are in favor of the patients. Right. So the extraction is a minimal, simple procedure, which you don't have to pay a lot about it, and unless and until you have a surgical kind of an extractions, so that might cost you a bit, but that is affordable to any common man. And regarding the implant, the implants depends on the variety of the bone, what you have, which implant suits your bone, which kind of an implant would really osseointegrate well into your bone, which has a biocompatibility. And we usually use a premium quality of an implant. Okay, every implant is made of titanium, but the choice of selection of an implant will be based on the patient's perspective. All right, so the cost and all, it is very feasible in Bharta Dental. We do offer with these financial helpful also. We do have a 0% interest charges and all. We tied up with various financial companies, so that once your documents has been produced, you might have a choice of utilizing those services as well. And so don't worry about your costs and this thing. Everything is negotiable in Partha Dental. Okay. And there's Indri Namaduri. Hello, sir. Doctor, can you tell me which implant for 92 years of old person? Can we give an implant in 92 years of old? Why not, sir? See, implants can start from, can be used at the age of 18 to till it doesn't have a end of an age. This age you cannot go with an implant. Any age who really require an implant can go ahead, sir. 92 years of old person, there's no contraindication, sir. So we do the procedures for around 90 years of age also. So we have that standard quality of an implant which will definitely suit the person. Okay. Chaitanya Challa, doctor, can I know about orthognathic surgery? Success rates. So there is no success rate in orthognathic surgery, sir. It all depends on the psychological acceptance of the patient. Usually in an orthognathic surgery, I keep on telling to all my patients, you must be psychologically fit to undergo an orthognathic surgery. Okay, the success rate lies in there. Okay, even though you wanted to have a straight profile, we can make that also. You wanted to have a square profile, that is also possible. It all depends on the evaluation, sir. We do a lot of mock surgeries in front of us doing orthognathic surgery. So after every diagnostic elements and all, we move on to the surgery. Unless or until the patient is feeling comfortable, the patient would obviously feel comfortable with the surgeries what we have performed so far. We had a great testimonials and great videos of those cases also, which are being posted on the Facebook. If you want, you can log on to facebook.com. Okay. Tony, does cancer in mouth look like when it starts? Does cancer in the mouth look like when it starts? See, there are two kinds of cancerous things which are to be known. First is like a precancerous condition and a cancerous condition. See, every lesion which appears to be in the mouth is not a cancerous condition. So we don't have to come to a conclusion that it might be a cancer kind of a thing. So we cannot directly come to a conclusion that there might be a chance of a leukoplakia sort of a thing, which appears white patches in the mouth. So that cannot be a cancerous lesion. You need to have a check with the doctor in the clinics, get a biopsy done, just go with the investigations, prior investigations advised by the doctor. Then you move on with the diagnosis part. Okay, so the cancerous lesions are various in type. Okay, so when it comes to oral kind of thing, you will have a squamous cell carcinoma is the most commonest thing which happens in the oral cavity. Okay, and Rehman Ramu, I hope you got the answer, Mr. Tony. Rehman Ramu, any recent advances in implant, please throw some light on it, doc. That's a great question, sir. Very pleased to answer you. Okay, any recent advances in implant? Yes, sir, we do follow almost all the recent advances in implant. Okay, we have a conventional kind of an implant, which is a two-piece and a single-piece implants. There's a three-piece implant as well. Now the world has already acknowledged the zirconia implant. It completely comes up with the crown part as well. Okay, so that the studies are under research, so it might take some time, but soonly it will be into the market. Okay, Nindril Namaduri, can we give 32 implants to replace 32 teeth in person mouth? What a strategic question, sir. This is seriously a keynote to be noted down. So we haven't tried of giving 32 implants to replace 32 teeth in mouth, because the literature and the study says the more number of the implants, there might be a chance of a failure of the implant. So the bone could not accept those many implants, sir. So in order to replace 32 teeth, you don't have to require 32 implants in mouth, because in 32 teeth, we will be having four wisdom teeth which are not useful in our oral cavity. Okay, those are the wisdom teeth. You don't have to replace them. There will be around 28 teeth in the mouth which comes under your occlusion and all. Okay, so you don't have to go with around 32 teeth in person. If at all, and based on your patient's interest, if that patient wants to have 32 teeth all in your mouth, yes, we are ready to do that, sir, but not with 32 kind of implants. We could place at least of around 24 implants and give around 28 crowns. That is the highest ever implants done in any patient's mouth. We have a record of doing around 24 implants in one patient, doing with all zirconia crowns. It's a very loving patient to us. Thank you, sir. Thanks for that question. And Chaitanya, thank you for advising query. Jagdish Jampala, I need clean in my mouth. Sir, what will do doctor? Okay. So see, sir, when it comes to cleaning of your teeth, it all depends on how you maintain your oral cavity. See, suppose you have a smoking habit, suppose even though you brush your teeth twice daily, it doesn't mean that your teeth should be clean enough so that there's nothing in my oral cavity, so I don't have to clean my teeth at all. So I don't have to consult a doctor to get my scaling or cleaning done. It is not that. Every patient has to have a clinical checkup with the doctor every 6 months of time. Okay, so we do have a great specialist in a parthodontal organization who have done their specialty programs in periodontitis and all. So there will be a periodontist who could address you well in getting your oral prophylaxis well done. And this is another question. Indranil, can we put 32 implants in mouth? That's fine. Is there anything called ceramic implants? Yes, sir, we do have a ceramic implant. So the studies are under research. The research is going on. So as of now, they are into the market, but not that well approved by any IDA or else like FDA approval. It's not been done to all those. The studies are going on. So soon it might reach to our this thing as well. Okay. Can we replace old outdated implants in patient mouth and get new implants afterwards and go for latest technology implants? Can we replace old outdated implants in patient's mouth? It's why not, sir? We can go ahead with the outdated implants, because see, there is a problem with the implant, existing implant in the mouth, because they probably that might be a conventional two-piece implant. There must be a problem with that regarding a hex drive and regarding a healing screw, or else with an abutment and all. There's a breakage of neck in the implant, neck in the abutment, or else there's a breakage in the head of an implant. So when in that cases, if you have to go for a replacement of that implant, you can just have a little bit of a surgical procedure to that to remove that implant, and in the same place you can go with the latest technology of implant. And Parthodontal is committed in doing the latest technology implants. So with the highest patient satisfaction as well. We does the treatments with the greatest latest technology available, which is in the market. Every sort of a technology which is with Parthodontal. Okay. Yes, sir, we can do the existing implant can be removed, outdated implant can be removed, and we can proceed out with the latest technology as well. Okay. Can we give two implants supported for fixing one teeth? That's a revolution which is going on in implants. Usually, we cannot give two implants in one teeth in the anterior tooth region, because every tooth will have a single root. Right? Single root. The posterior teeth, which are our masticatory teeth, which are helpful in chewing and all, they does have two roots. So there is a great interradicular bone, what we call it as a, if you can see the posterior teeth here, so it does have two roots, right? It does have two roots. So you can place two implants in two roots. When you come to an anterior teeth, you'll be having a single root. So you can, there's no place to accommodate two roots, two implants in one tooth. Okay, there are indications and contraindications as well when placing two implants in a single tooth. Okay, not every case is suitable to give two implants for fixing one tooth. But the literature and the studies says that every single tooth which has two roots, if you could preserve a great intraradicular bone, we can proceed with two implants, two good implants, and stabilize them if it is your organization having a great intraoral welding as well. So we can stabilize those. Okay. Raymond Ramo, let me know about success rate for implants for how many years. Yeah. Good question, sir. The success rate for implant is like we at Partha Dental does a premium quality of an implant. Okay, so we does with the premium quality of an implant. The minimum osseointegrating phase for an implant to get well in, adapted into the bone will be around 3 to 6 months of time. Okay, in that period, we would come to know across, we would come across a few failures and all, but there might be always a replacement option as well. So once well the implant gets osseointegrated into the bone, okay, so there won't be any kind of a failure, any kind of a failure in the upcoming years. So it, you can easily take it granted, sir, once the implant gets well osseointegrated, a minimum time of around 20-25 years we would promise to the patients. Okay, there won't be any issues at all in the success rate or in the failure rate at all with the Partha Dental. Okay, if implant becomes loose, then we can put new implant in same place later. Yes, why not, sir? Usually we do see, it's not that we shouldn't say that there is no failure at all. We do see a lot of cases, compromised cases and all. So we do evaluate every case in particular with the particular diagnostics things and all, and we move on to the case to treat, to give 100% satisfactory results to the patients. So if at all the implant becomes loose, yes, there is always a possibility of placing another implant in the same socket. It is because, see, you place an implant of around size 4.5 into 15, 16 mm diameter of an implant. If that fails, in usually in a failure rate, in a failure of an implant, the opposing implant, I mean the implant and the surrounded area gets infected due to any systemic conditions or else, so due to any bacterial and all, so you'll have a huge amount of bone loss surrounding that implant. Then you can go ahead with another big implant of a bigger dimension of size and just place it back into that, provided with a great great irrigation and with a good maintenance of that socket and all, you can easily place another implant in the same socket. So there's no worry at all with that, sir. So these will be the strategic two-piece implants. Yes. So they comes up, the implants will be in the bone and you can take the support of a denture and just fix it off. So patients who doesn't have teeth in both the upper and the lower arches, they can happily come place. We do have a types of treatment plans, various treatment plans and various dental perspectives. So we would go, we can proceed. We do have various options to the patients who are completely edentulous. We just give two implants with a denture. We can give four implants and give a fixed partial denture. We can place around six implants and give a great metal ceramic bridge. We can place around eight implants and just give a great zirconia crowns as well. So these are the treatment part varies on with different kinds of patients as well. But there should be a good enough amount of bone should be there also. All right. So implant is the best advanced technology which is available only at the best advanced. If you want to get a best implant done with the best latest advanced technology, come visit Bharta Dental. Meet the best specialist in India who are recognized in India, who the world is looking at Bharta Dental implantologists as well. So come to a Bharta Dental, get an implant done, and walk out with a great smile. That's all Bharta Dental is committed to. Okay. And let us talk about the periodontal condition in an implant, in surrounding the implant and all. So there will be, we usually see a few cases where there will be the adjacent tooth not in that great periodontal condition, and there will be a gingival problems surrounding the tooth and all, whether the tooth has to go for extraction, the evaluation procedures will be taken place, and the periodontist plays a key role in success of an implant. The Bharta Dental works with a team of doctors which comprises of all super specialities which are there in dentistry. We does have endodontists who looks after the root canal specialist. We could do call them as a root canal specialist who deals with the tooth who has a decay, who has a severe pain on the tooth which is very firm indeed. He addresses you with a root canal treatment as an endodontist. Okay, when it comes to a periodontist, you have a gingival problem, you have a gum problems, you have a mobility of your teeth. This is a case where a periodontist comes into play. Okay, this case is a purely periodontal condition case. You could see a dental plaque lining around surrounding the teeth. So that goes for a great oral prophylaxis. We could stabilize the tooth by doing a laser kind of a surgery also. Bharta Dental is having a latest advanced in lasers as well. Okay, so and when it comes to our tooth, sir, my tooth is a pretty mobile. The patients who come to us ask us, sir, my tooth is a pretty mobile, but I don't want to go for an extraction of that tooth because that I cannot lose my natural appearance of that tooth. So what should I do? Can you retain my tooth and give the tooth a normal position? So in those cases as well, we Bharta Dental does a lot of research studies in preserving such kind of cases. So we does the simple procedures. If that case can be dealt with, we do in that simple procedure. The case has to be dealt with a kind of a better addressment of that case. We does with the latest advanced technologies as well, called as the lasers as well. Okay, and the smokers. And in smoking conditions, usually we'll have a bit of a depigmentation happening on the gingival gums. Gums is nothing but your reddish part which you see lying the tooth. So usually in those conditions, gingival conditions and all, we does a depigmentation procedures which are done under local anesthesia as well. So our doctors are very much and well trained in treating those conditions as well. See, every case, if it is a periodontal case, see, this is another case. So there is a lot of conditions in influencing the periodontal, this thing. So you don't have to worry about your tooth loosening or else your tooth is not in proper position or else you have a lot of decay on your tooth and all. So you don't have to worry all those such things. Our doctors are very much specialized in treating the patient with the highest priority care. All right. And let us talk about trauma as well. Let us talk about a little bit of a trauma as a maxillofacial surgeons, a role of a maxillofacial surgeons in dentistry. I would like to share a few things of a maxillofacial surgeon. So maxillofacial surgery is a specialty department which we study that course for around 3 years of time, doing a various number of cases. And what importance does a maxillofacial surgeon have? So it is very simple. It is a head, okay? This is a skull, okay? So if you could see in the second image, the bones have been dislocated, okay? The bones have been dislocated. So that is the maxillofacial origin, okay? And that is, the second picture shows you the plating and all, which is done to stabilize those infused maxillary skull bones, okay? So just a brief introduction to that cases, to trauma cases. Usually what happens in maxillofacial surgery or when the patient had a trauma, all right? So usually in patients who had a trauma to maxillofacial origin, so there will be a dislocation of your bones. Your bones, your skull bones get dislocated, causing a huge trauma, huge blood loss and all. There might be a neuro problems related to that when you had a head trauma. Okay, you have a subconjunctival ecchymosis and all. See, when you have a trauma case, you will be having a subconjunctival ecchymosis. So what is to be ruled out in those kind of cases? See, usually when a patient had a trauma, who is fit to get admitted or in the hospital, we does with a preliminary investigations called a CT brain, evaluate the brain. If the neurophysician gives a fitness certificate that you can proceed on with your oral surgery procedures and all, we would rule out with maxillofacial injuries to the face. And if there is any injury to your frontal bone, your nasal bone, your zygomatic bone, your maxillary bone, or your mandibular bone, then we just investigate through CT images and rule out what best can be done to the maxillofacial origin. So if that has to undergo open reduction. So we all, the oral maxillofacial surgeon is specialist in doing those kind of cases. All right. It's Ajay, my brother is leaving US in 1 week. Can he undergo any complication, undergo implants and any complication? That was a great question, sir. We does a lot of cases of those kind because see, usually a patient who wants to get an implant done, who's leaving in 1 week to US. See, usually in 1 week of a time, we have a best advanced in Partha Dental, which is a single piece implanter. So the piece, if that was in an aesthetic zone is nothing but you have a missing teeth in your anterior segment, anterior portion. So you can directly go with a strategic single piece implant, which doesn't have an abutment to that itself. So put a temporary crown onto that. You can directly go to your office and all. Our implants are so standard implants. So there's no problem at all, sir. If your brother is leaving in 1 week, do send him to Partha Dental. We doctors in Partha Dental are ready to treat the patients of such kind. Challenging cases are only done at Partha Dental. Indriel Namaduri, 60,000 per single piece implant available in your hospital. Sir, we do not quote the implants in a higher specific rate unless and until it is acceptable or if it is really required to the patient. Unless certainly we don't charge much of implant making the patient problematic. So we does the implants in higher price, but it provided the patient, the acceptance of the patient and the availability of the bone. If it is a compromised case, you have to go for a higher quality of an implant. We make the patient explain every certain procedure why the implant has to be cost effective when compared to other implants. We make the patient educate well to that and then we proceed on with that procedures. Does implants cause radiation while taking MRI and CT scan? Not at all, sir. This is a titanium material as by the orthopedicians who does a fracture alignment when they have a fracture, right? So they do have a fracture and they join the bones by doing a plating and all. The same way you don't have a tooth, which we can put just a single implant. And so these implants does not cause any radiation while you go to an MRI and the CT scan. Okay. A lot of questions, great questions today when compared to earlier session. And hello, this is again introducing you. This is Dr. Vijay. I'm a maxillofacial surgeon and a senior implantologist of Partha Dental. Partha Dental, he is a huge corporate dental chain in South India. Soon it is going to expand throughout India. So the dreams of Partha Dental organization family members is going to fulfill in a short span of time. So Partha Dental comprises of 88 odd branches, which are well divided in AP, Telangana and Bangalore respectively. Well, I do have a few questions. We'll get back to you with my topic now. My topic today is role of a maxillofacial surgery in dentistry. Wow, there's a question. I just missed it out. I would read that question. I heard good quality implant. Yes. Hi, doctor. Hello, Aditi Natikar. Hi, doctor. My aunt got a dental implant placed earlier. Doctor asked her to wait for 3 months' time. I'm watching your show. You're saying that implant once placed can be given immediately. Can you explain me which? Please, what is the difference? Madam, it is very pretty simple. See, we do have our varieties of implants, right? So whichever implant does suit your aunt, the doctor explains you about that procedure. It is pretty simple, madam. There are two varieties of an implant. It is a conventional strategic two-piece implant and a conventional single-piece implant. Okay, so I would suggest or request your aunt to have a dental checkup with the implantologist. Get best diagnostic done at Partha Dental. Get an OPG scan, which does involve all your teeth, can be seen in one picture. Get that OPG done. It is almost available in every Partha Dental branch. So you can have a OPG done, visualize all your teeth, condition of your teeth can be visualized in that OPG. Get it done and get your queries done with your implantologist. So which implant does suit your aunt can be easily done, okay? And the difference between that implant and this procedure is pretty simple, madam. See, if you're placing a conventional two-piece implant in your bone, any implant is placed in the bone, right? So if that implant is placed in the bone, so to fix the crown in a two-piece implant, you may have to wait for 3 months of time, because immediate abutment cannot be given on the place, because usually after placement of the implants, we does our job in a correct way, but we cannot really depend on the patient's perspective, right? So if the patient tends to be a bite or chew on the neck, on the implant and all, it may tend to result in a failure, right? Or do implants cause an infection to our body? Never, sir. Never, madam. Manu manya. Never. It is that because every implant is made of titanium. All right. So every implant is made of titanium, and which is biocompatible to our body. Okay. And it, which is healthier as well. See, usually in a natural teeth, what happens is your natural teeth will have a periodontium surrounding the tooth and all. You'll have bone loss surrounding that. Even if you're affected by diabetes, you are a smoker. So there are various factors which influence the bone loss to a tooth. But whereas when it comes to an implant, once the implant gets well oscillated, provided you're maintaining the great part of an implant, if you're not affected by any of your health issues and your implant is not at all infectious to our body. Partha Dental is committed, and Partha Dental scrutinizes every implant. Our implantologist scrutinizes every implant, which is very good and effective, economical, and in patients' healthy nature. We does only those kind of implants. Okay. Gold implant is available. Yes, sir. Gold implant is usually gold implant is not available, sir. Because see, usually you can get a gold ceramic crown, but not a gold implant, sir. See, there will be a gold plated or gold coating kind of an implant, which is not made of gold, because gold cannot be taken up by the body. See, the implant has some variations which should suit our natural body. See, it is a foreign particle which has to be there in the body forever. So any kind of a material which cannot be taken up by the body is not suitable. All right, there's one more question. Ajay, what is the best way to replace teeth, implants or bridge? So such a lovely question, Mr. Ajay. And see, it is very simple. There are a few factors. See, I could come to your question like this. There are a few factors. If you have to have a replacement of a tooth, right? If you have to have a replacement of your natural teeth, you don't have a natural teeth for many years and all, just come to the clinic, just have a consultation with the doctor. The doctor would obviously advise you to go with a diagnostic investigation. Once the diagnostic investigation is done, you can visualize your natural appearance in a diagnostic tools like what we have, an intraoral camera, orthopantomogram. So in that we visualize your condition of the bone, condition of your mouth, condition of your stay under condition of your oral cavity. Based on your everything, we move on with a bridge. Supposing you are diabetic, implant is not a contraindication. Neither the bridge is not a contraindication. So the condition of your the condition of your tooth relies mainly on a bridge. Okay, the condition of your bone relies mainly on implants. That's all your question. That's all my answer to your question. And one more question there. Yep, Rahman, implants and systemic disease, any correlation? Yeah, why not, sir? There is a relation between the, see, if you're getting an implant done, you're not affected by any of your systemic diseases. You have a systemic diseases, you don't have an effect on your implants. That's all, it is not interlinked or interrelated to any of your, those things. So the systemic disease, you have your systemic disease. The implants are contraindicated, I would say. It's no, you can directly go with an implant. See, implants are only contraindicated in few cases, very rare conditions, very rarest of conditions. Likewise, the patient who had a cancerous surgery, okay, who underwent a radiation therapy, okay. So when the patient goes for a radiation therapy and the patient is affected by a radiation gamma protection rays and all, the patient has to go with an implant. In those kind of cases, we visualize every perspective treatment and every best aspect to treat that kind of a cases. So usually the patient who undergoes a radiation therapy and all, there is a chance of a radiation necrosis to the bone. See, the necrosis happens to the bone usually just because the radiation gamma rays, it decreases the vascular supply of the bone. So in those kind of cases, it is pretty risky or it all depends on the patient's surgical condition, what kind of a surgery and to which organ he has gone for a radiation. Okay, so in those kind of cases, it is a pretty contraindicated, or else we could say it is a pretty complicated procedure in kind of cases of radiation therapy. And Indranil Namuduri, heart attack patient, can they go for non-magnetic implant? Sir, there is no complication with the heart attack patients. See, usually, see, the patients who had a heart cardiac problems, would have underwent an angioplasty, the stenting done to the heart, or else if the patient who underwent a coronary artery bypass grafting, it is a bypass surgery. So in those kind of cases, it is the implants are not at all contraindicated, sir. But the cardiologist puts the patient on an antiplatelet drugs, which are in form of to make the blood thinning to the which pumps to your heart. So in those kind of cases, the patient will be on Ecosprin or Clopidap tablets and all. So in those kind of cases, we would want the patient to get a written consent or a video consent, whatever the consent form, if you could get from the cardiologist stating that you can proceed all with your dental procedures, we are ready to do with that, sir. So it is not a complication in the heart attack patient. Great question. Farooq Bhai, hi. Satyanarayan, hi. And Khantidat Sujata, hi. Satyanarayan, hi. Shankar, hi. Jai Prakash, hi. Hello, all. Yeah, this is Dr. Vijay. I'm a maxillofacial surgeon of Heart Dental and a senior implantologist who've been well associated and been working for many years in Heart Dental. It's a great organization and a great platform for a budding dentist who have recently come out of the colleges and institutions. This is a great platform to join and get well associated. You see a lot of cases in Partha Dental. We just treat an innumerous patient with an innumerous patient satisfaction. Okay, and I will talk about the rarest cases in maxillofacial surgery as well. What kind of cases we do treat on the maxillofacial surgery department. So this will be a case of a cleft case. Okay, this will be a cases of a cleft case. Usually we don't notice who does these kind of cases. See, maxillofacial surgeons are well trained in treating the cases of a cleft as well. Okay, so cleft is nothing but a fusion of two bones, soft tissue that may be due to a failure in fusion of it as a cleft. So maxillofacial surgeons are the specialists who can deal with the cleft surgeries as well. And kids having cavities, he may not cooperate procedure. How could you deal and address this problem? That's a great question, sir Ajay. And see, usually the patients are a bit psychologically affected because of these procedures. See, we need to evaluate, we need to understand the child nature. Partha Dental has a great infrastructure. You have a pediatric patient, you have a pediatric, it's nothing but a kid patient, this younger patient who's around 3-4 years or 10 years old, below 10 years old, who have an apprehension in entering the clinic. Seeing a dental clinical setup and seeing a doctor with an apron and stent in his neck, definitely will fear for the patient could not withstand the dental procedure. Supposing he sees a injection kind of a thing, the needles which are on the clinic, and the patient is not at all cooperating in a dental clinic setup. The Partha Dental has numerous advancement, which is cases under a sedative anesthetics. Our doctors are really specialist in dealing the children. So we just give a sedative kind of a thing, which is not harmful to the patients at all. And the children, we would create an atmosphere in the dental clinic such that the children feels very comfortable and addresses and could cooperate with the patients, could cooperate with the doctors as well. Okay, so Partha Dental is committed in treating the kids without any fear also. Anything about CBCT, sir? How much does it help in implant placement? Great, sir. That is a great investigation could be done. See, usually the CBCT could evaluate the thickness and the depth and the amount of the bone and the quality of the bone can be analyzed by a CBCT. So Usually, we every case we don't follow blindly the CBCT, but a case is of a full mouth case which has to be replaced, which is very compromised indeed. The if at all the implantologist feels that this case I would require a CBCT, then we would advise the patient to go with the CBCT and get the analysis done, evaluations done, a surgery, preliminary surgery is also done to that case. We just take a preliminary impressions, pour the cast and see, do a surgical stent to that, make a surgical stent of that case, and we then have a CBCT evaluation, then we could go with the procedure. Okay. Yeah. Why few implant cases fail? So usually what happens, see, it all depends on, see, I could not directly complain or say that the implant fails just because of your poor maintenance on the patients. It is like throwing a stone on the patient. That is not a correct aspect to talk about when it comes to a failure rate. There are many factors which could influence the failure of an implant. See, there may be a systemic causes or local factors which may influence the failure of an implant. See, the patient is a smoker. He tells you that I don't smoke, I have already quit smoking. The patient tells you that I am an alcoholic. After placement of an implant, I'll be stopping my alcohol. And the patient tells that I am non-diabetic and the patient is already diabetic. If he's a diabetic and he's not on medication, if he's a diabetic or a type 2 diabetic goes on insulin medication, he's not using his proper drug set time in a regular interval of time. So then in those kind of cases, if the patient says that I do brushing twice daily, I do a oral rinses every hourly to maintain a good oral hygiene. So I'm doing that in every case, sir, but even then, why could it fail? See, it all depends on the patient's metabolism, all right? So the implant has to get well osseointegrated in the body. You know, there are many causes and reasons for a failure of an implant. See, that is a foreign body. See, implant is nothing but it is a foreign body which will be in the bone forever. Our implants are not like we place an implant, sir, it will definitely come for 5 years, 3 years, 10 years, 15 years and all. Our implants are forever. All right. There may be a failure of an osseointegration as well during the osseointegrating procedure. Sometimes there is a traumatic to those implants and all, you don't have a proper occlusion, there might be a chance of a failure. But Partha Dental is committed to see to it that every single implant or every single individual doesn't feel anything or doesn't feel anything dissatisfied in getting treated in Partha Dental. So Partha Dental has bought an innumerous and various track records which is widely spread throughout India. Partha Dental has done the highest number of dental implants. Would you believe that? Partha Dental has done a highest number of implants, highest number of smile designs. Smile design is nothing but Partha Dental, the smile designing is nothing but aligning your teeth in a proper occlusion, or else making the tooth look 1,000 times better what you have. So Partha Dental is committed in delivering or rendering great services to the people who really require a dental problems. Okay. Well, and hello Kalyan sir, how are you? I'm good, thank you sir. Hi doctor, I'm on the tea for already. Question has been answered, madam. Yes, and let's move on to the topic today, the role of a maxillofacial surgeon in dentistry. See, usually when it comes to dentistry, The maxillofacial surgeon only does treatments of a wisdom tooth, which are wisdom tooth. You could see a wisdom tooth there underlying, which is in a sleeping position. So maxillofacial surgeons are a specialist who does cases which are related to your maxillofacial origin, right? So the wisdom tooths, which are of various kinds, supposing you have a mesiangular impaction, horizontal impaction, vertical impaction, okay? So there are various kinds of tooth which could be impacted as well. So, and coming on to the orthognathic surgery, the importance of an orthognathic surgery to any patient. See, I could say the orthognathic surgeries are done to the patients who doesn't have a great skeletal profile. Supposing the patient who has a protrusion of a maxilla, who has a retrusion of a mandible, okay, so when he looks and he is not satisfied with what the profile he has in his to see throughout his life, so the patients who wants a greater profile to look good, if at all the patient wants to get married in a span time of around 6 months, 1 year, the patients wants to have look better. We do have a bridal makeup kind of a thing also, which is a smile design. Okay, veneering is done in part of dental. So which are related to the dental problems, we address with doing smile designs and tooth bleaching and all. You can get a great tooth, tooth in a normal, aesthetic appearance. And when it comes to skeletal deformities, skeletal is nothing but your maxilla is not properly designed, right? So you have a protrusive maxilla, which is nothing but you have a bulkiness of your bone, and what is to be done? So I don't look good, sir. My maxilla is protruding out, and when I smile, my gums are visible. So what is the best option can we do? So in those kind of cases, the maxillofacial surgeries play a key role in treating an patients who wants to undergo an orthognathic surgery, right? So we does the procedures under GA. It is a simple procedure. And this is a rarest case who's a foreigner who had come to Partha Dental, who wants a greater smile appearance of a face. That is a before and after pics. Okay, so we have done a facial makeover to that patient who had a protrusive maxilla. So we have done a procedure called a Leafoot 1 procedure. We down fracture the maxillary complete bone and superior position it and give a greater profile. The patient is very, very happy and had already represented with many patients. So you want to have those visualize those kind of cases which are done in Partha Dental. We do have an official page of parthadental.in. So you could log on to that, become a subscriber, see the videos, testimonials, cases, and the feedbacks which are given by the patients and all, educate and get educated through the social activity. Likewise, we're doing a Facebook activity live program. Our specialties are specialists are committed in educating the patients manner. See, if you want to have a consultation or to visit a Partha Dental clinic, you could just dial a number of 040, which is shown to me behind 0404142000. Right, this is a case I was talking about, a mandibular advancement. See, if you could see in this picture, the mandible is slightly protruded, and there is a opening of the mouth. There is an inclined maxilla. So the patient wants to get a straight profile. So what do you do? The maxillofacial surgeons, what does they do? See, it is very simple. The mandible has to go a little back. So in order to do that, the procedure we could do to that patient is a bilateral sagittal split osteotomy, which is a BSSO surgery. So the mandible, at least of depending on the cephalometric analysis, what we done here, okay, based on the analysis and based on the diagnostic part and all, we evaluate the case. And what best can be done to that case, which is already visualized and we does with the mock surgery, all right? So we visualize in every aspect and we don't leave an inch of a corner, you know, to make the patient unsatisfied, okay? Everything has been dealt, and after that we have done a BSSO procedure and a little bit of anterior maxillary osteotomy, which is done to the maxillary bone. We just protrude that maxilla and put a superior positioning and do a plating to that bone to get a great profile indeed. Now she has a great straight profile and the patient is pretty happy indeed. So we get a great referrals from those kind of cases, those kind of surgical cases, okay? And Partha Dental is committed in always in treating challenging cases, in treating different kind of cases, okay? And the maxillofacial surgery. Maxillofacial surgery is, I could say, which is a super speciality department. Super speciality department when compared to the other dentists, okay? Because it is lined and tied up with multi treatments, so which deals with around